Rochester Zebras in the road black, the black shorts, black jerseys, gold numbers and letters. The Fairfield Falcons in their home whites, white shorts, white jerseys, blue numbers and blue letters. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. The Rochester Zebras will go right to left on your radio dial. Obviously Fairfield left to right. This is the consolation game of the Winning Edge Holiday Tournament. It'll be Kennedy and also Lance to jump center for their respective squads. The final game of the 2012 portion of the regular season is underway with DeWitt and Fairfield controlling the tip. Rochester immediately goes to that man defense. Lance has it at the elbow right, feeds down low to Scott. His turnaround jumper is no good. Rebound fought for. They're going to say last touch by DeWitt and the Falcons. It'll go to Rochester.
Looks like Fairfield's got a guard that likes to post up. It was the man Al Garrick was defending, went to the post. So we'll see if that trend continues. As Fairfield comes out in a 2-2-1, three-quarters court trap.
Korn has it to a streaking Holland. Alec Holland on the wing, now top to Garrick. 2-3 zone by the Fairfield Falcons. Now Odell high on the left side, swings right side to Holland. Holland looking to bounce past the corner of the free throw line. Can't get it to him. Gives to Garrick in the left corner. Jump pass right wing to Holland. Now top to Odell at the volleyball line to Garrick. Couple of dribbles. Now to Holland high on the right side to a wide open Odell in the right corner. To Kennedy. Back to Odell. In the lane to Korn. Turnaround jumper is good, and Rochester strikes first. Nice ball movement by the Zebras to get that open look for a Korn.
You got a lot of those possessions against the zone when everybody touches the ball and you end up with a made
shot.
That's
right. Seth Korn, nice confident shot. The backdoor layup by Rhodes is no good, and the ball is tipped out of bounds on the rebound by the Zebras. It'll stay with Fairfield baseline left with under a minute gone. Make that over a minute gone in the first quarter. Rochester up 2-0. Line will look to trigger it in over Korn. Line looking, lobs it in to Lance. Now left wing to Rhodes, quickly to DeWitt, swings it to Line. Line at the elbow right, works against Seth Korn. Dump pass down low to Lance against Kennedy. Jumper off the glass is no good. Luke Kennedy with the board. Nice defense by Kennedy, stood his ground, and then gets ahead to Odell. Odell high on the right wing, bounce pass back to Holland, near side to Garrick. 2-3 zone by the Falcons to Holland, right wing to Odell. Down low to Kennedy. Kennedy kicks it out to Odell for a three, right wing. It's good, and Rochester up 5-0 with 6.5 to play in the first quarter.
Still good possession. Went inside out. You know, didn't settle for the three on the first shot. Moved the ball a little bit on that side of the floor and took a good open look.
DeWitt quickly down low to Lance. Backs his way in against Kennedy. Against a double team, he travels, and Rochester going to get it back.
Got to be a frustrating start for Fairfield. They're moving the ball a little bit themselves. All three of their shots have been inside 5 feet, just haven't got one to fall yet.
Well, it's quite obvious that they want to go to Lance down low. They feel like they have an advantage offensively on the blocks with Lance, and they've tried the last two times. Rochester doing a good job double-teaming and triple-teaming him. Rochester up 5-0. Holland penetrates the zone, gives it out to Korn. He'll take the jumper from the baseline. It's no good. Ball being tipped around, and DeWitt for the Falcons comes out of there with it. DeWitt across the timeline, out of line. Line on the left wing. He'll spot up for a long three. It's short. Draws nothing but a little bit of iron. Odell with the rebound to Holland. Alec Holland will go throw up a shot. No good. The putback by Kennedy is good. Rochester up 7-0, and Falcons will use a timeout. It's a 30-second. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. 30-second
timeout. RTC Channel 4 is happy to offer the following videos for this week. You will see the RHS Holiday Concert daily at 11 a.m., 3:30 p.m. and 7 o'clock p.m. And you may also watch RTC's own segment called This Week on Channel 4 at 10:30 a.m., 1:30 p.m. and 6 o'clock p.m. If you have a suggestion for a future Channel 4 video, please call D. Brown at RTC number 223-2191. Keep up to date with RTC happenings by liking Rochester Telephone Company on Facebook. Merry Christmas and a very happy new year.
WROI Rochester. Zebra Basketball. WROI.
Back at Tippecanoe Valley for the second round of the Winning Edge Holiday Tournament. Fairfield inbounds a basketball underneath the Rochester basket and then turns it over down court and a foul coming against Fairfield.
Yeah, Zebras went to a little half-court trap themselves. Nice job by Coach Reinhold. You know they were scheming against what the Zebras had been doing the previous possessions. Come out of a timeout with a different defensive look. Good call.
Rochester up 7-0. Seth Korn hard to the basket. His jumper from 10 feet is good, and Rochester up now 9-0 with 5:10 to play in the first quarter. Line has it out high against Seth Korn, who guards him at the volleyball line. Now to Scott, bounce pass to DeWitt, quickly left wing to Line. Line drives the baseline, cut off by Seth Korn of the double team, and jump pass outside to Scott. Scott at the elbow, ball is loose, and we're going to have a foul on Alec Gehrig, and it'll be out of bounds to Fairfield.
Looks like that was a loose ball situation. Alec had knocked it loose, both kind of reaching for it, but the referee saw Gehrig as a reach in.
Fairfield will bring in Nate Miller, and Line will come out for the Fairfield Falcons. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Early into this basketball game, Rochester up 9-0. Bounce pass comes in bounds from Rhodes, and then Rhodes standing out of bounds, grabs the deflected ball, and that's a turnover against Fairfield.
You know, you talked about what kind of starts the Zebras one. I think Coach Ryan Holt would have dialed this one up. 9-0,
3 minutes in. I'd say the pregame speech and the walkthrough this morning and maybe the blow-up last night helped, and then Kennedy, cross-court pass is picked off by Rhodes. He'll go in for the right-handed layup. It's no good, and then the ball is knocked out of bounds by DeWitt, and Rochester going to get it back. Well, I tell you what, these guys are letting them play early, Tony.
Yeah, they are, a little bit like we saw last night. You know, the Rochester Northwood game, I think 5 fouls called the entire first half. Seems a similar style here.
4:35 to play in the first half. In the first quarter. John Odell lights it up from 18 feet, no good. And the rebound to Lance and Fairfield. Quickly to Scott, gives the head to Rhodes. Rhodes on the right wing, back to Scott, fakes a three. Now to Wick, quickly left side to Miller. Feeds down low to Lance, back to the wing against Kennedy. Kicks it out to end of Rhodes. He'll fire a three from the right side, is in and out, no good. Offensive rebound to Scott. Scott in the paint, gives to Lance. He backs his way in against Kennedy. His shot off the glass is good. And Fairfield has their first point coming at the 4:10 mark of the first quarter. And it's a 7-point lead now for Rochester at 9-2. 2-2-1 press by Fairfield. Out to Holland. No look pass to Kennedy. His 10-footer from the baseline is no good. Rebound fought for. Fairfield comes out of there to Rhodes. Now quickly to DeWitt. Misses a wide-open Lance on the other end of the floor. Out to DeWitt now. Quickly to Miller. He'll try a three from the wing. It's short. Gets his own rebound. And now down low to Rhodes. Has it deflected right into the hands of Lance. He puts it in for two. Somebody might want to block out the shooter.
Yeah, Zebras haven't done a very good job blocking out. They've gotten away with some missed shots, but they've got to take care of those defensive boards. And down here on offense, they're a little bit more up-tempo than they have been.
Rochester did a great job breaking that 2-2-1 press, but John Odell goes to the basket hard, but took too many steps doing so, and he travels, and it'll go to Fairfield. Rochester up 9-4 with 3:25 to play in the first quarter.
You know, those first few possessions, they're moving the ball, getting great looks, open shots. These last few possessions when they haven't scored, quick shots again, kind of like we saw last night.
Rhodes almost has his pocket picked, the ball in the backcourt, picked up by Fairfield, and we're going to have a foul coming on Kennedy. And the new Falcon in the game is Clay Bontrager, the 6'3 sophomore. And the hustle play there resulted in a foul for Luke Kennedy.
Yeah, good hustle play by Luke. The big thing is now he's got to make that adjustment. Okay, that was a good hustle play. You don't need to make that play now that you've got one. You've got to play smart. You stay on the floor.
Miller to Bontrager, near side to Rhodes. Rhodes looking down low to Scott, has him on the baseline, tipped away, back to Rhodes on the right wing. Now inside the arc for Fairfield. Rochester in the man-to-man defense. Miller feeds in the blocks to Rhodes. His turnaround jumper in the paint, tie off the glass, no good. And the rebound to Gehrig. Alec Gehrig then has his pass stolen by DeWitt. Now quickly to Rhodes. To a wide open Scott. His three on the way is good from the right wing. And all of a sudden, Fairfield now, Tony, on a 7-0 run.
Yep, game of runs. 9-0 first by Rochester, now 7-0 for Fairfield.
We have seen that a lot this year with Rochester and against Rochester. Gehrig high on the right wing for Rochester for the Zebras. 2-3 zone still by Fairfield with 2:20 to play. In the first quarter, Rochester's lead has been cut to 2, once 9-0, now 9-7. Odell bounce pass to Gehrig on the right wing. Gehrig goes to the basket hard. He's fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two. Nice job by Gehrig by getting into that 2-3 zone and putting the shot up off the glass and being fouled.
Yeah, he's done a nice job this year of it's that right wing, as you look at it, of hitting that seam and that pull-up jumper. He took it all the way in and drew the foul. He's going to shoot two.
Alec Gehrig's first one is good. Rochester up 10-7. Fairfield back to their bench, and they'll bring in John Stack. And Rhodes will sit down. Gehrig will have one more. Second one is on the way for the junior, and it's good. 11-7. Rochester up with 2:10 to play in the first quarter. Rochester in a 2-3 zone, it looks like, or maybe 2-1-2.
Yeah, 2-1-2 with Canada in the middle.
Scott for three. Good. That's her second consecutive three, and now the lead is down to one for Rochester at 11-10. Holland breaks the man-to-man press. Works the right side, loses the basketball, picked up by Fairfield. Now quickly ahead to Stack. Stack on the wing. Spots up for three, top of the key. It's short. And the ball being tipped around, we're going to have a foul down low. It looks like it's going to be on Rochester. We'll wait and see.
I think they might get Alec Gehrig for a hold. Both players trying to block each other out. But they're going to get Alec Holland for kind of a wrap around as he was trying to block out the Fairfield player.
Minute 43 to play in the first quarter. The Zebras up 11-10. And Fairfield looking to get the ball in bounds. Miller studying. Finally gets it in to Bontrager. Bontrager against Kennedy in the paint. Gives a Stack. Stack kicks it out to Miller. His three is no good. Alec Holland, the weak side rebound, and he runs up the right side of the floor. Holland now gives to Garrick on the near side. Alec Garrick in the corner to Kennedy. Luke drives the baseline hard. Pull-up jumper is short. And the rebound to Fairfield. DeWitt quickly ahead to Bontrager. Loses the handle. Back to DeWitt. Now left side to Stack. Back to DeWitt. Middle of the floor. Now near side to Miller. Miller looking for Brooks. Looking for Scott. No good. There's three. No good by DeWitt. Scott's putback is going to be deflected out of bounds. And it'll stay with DeWitt. Make that Fairfield baseline right as Lance comes back into the game. And Scott's assist.
Probably five or six offensive rebounds for Fairfield so far this quarter. And that's going to come back to bite you, especially when you're playing man-to-man. You hate to see it as a coach. You're responsible for a player. And when you're playing man-to-man, you know who you should be blocking out. You got to get that job done.
It's been Rochester's Achilles heel basically every game. Miller's three is no good. Weak side rebound by DeWitt. DeWitt against Odell, and he travels.
Good break for the Zebras there. You know, I think Holland was probably fouled over the back. He kind of fell, that got pulled down a little bit. Good thing referee called travel because that was should have been a foul against
DeWitt.
Yeah.
55 seconds to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 11-10. Alec Holland through the center circle for the Zebras. Now sets up shot between the rings of the volleyball line. Works against some 2-3 zone of the Fairfield Falcons. Around the double team is Garrick. Gives to Holland. 15-footer is good. Alec Holland has his first two of the game and is 13-10 with 30 seconds to play in the first quarter.
And all five starters have scored for the Zebras.
Outstanding. DeWitt looking to get it across. Gets to the Stack across the timeline. Cross court pass to Miller. Miller almost has his pass stolen. DeWitt rolls around the floor. And we're going to have a tie-up, and Rochester going to get it. Rolling around a new travel.
Good sign for the Zebras. Yeah, like we said, all five starters have scored. And you look over at the Fairfield ledger, Scott has six and Lance has four. So they've only had two players score.
Right. 18 seconds to play first quarter. Rochester by three at 13-10. Alec Garrick has his pass deflected out of bounds. And we'll try it again on the far sideline. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Consolation game of the Winning Edge Holiday Tournament here at Tippecanoe Valley High School. Rochester has the basketball with 17.6 to play in the first quarter. Nice lead pass by Garrick to Korn. It crosses the timeline to Holland. Holland in the paint. Kicks it into the corner to Garrick. To a wide open Odell for three from the right wing is short. And the rebound to Fairfield. And Luke Kennedy just picked up foul number two for coming over the back.
Yeah, that's one of those situations where maybe too quick of a shot. You'd like to get the last one. That's exactly for that reason. You get the final shot of the quarter. You don't have to worry about that. Kind of a quick shot there. But Luke's still got to know his situation. You know, long rebound.
Right.
You got one foul. End of the quarter. You just got to let it go and play good defense, and the kid gets the rebound.
Well, Cy Holland, because of the second foul by Kennedy, comes into the game. And quickly ahead is DeWitt, who got away with a travel to Lance with one. The shot at the buzzer is no good by Miller. After one, Rochester leading 13-10. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Why purchase a new or pre-owned vehicle from Mike Anderson? This is John Adair, General Manager, and after visiting with a satisfied customer, this is what they told me. I never felt pressured. I appreciated the salesperson's honest approach. He explained why we might want to consider a different vehicle than the one we originally thought I wanted. I was amazed at how easy it was to get financed, and my salesperson took the time to explain all the features of my car before I even drove off the lot. So the fact is, at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram Truck, we want every one of our customers to say, I love my car, after the sale. We mean it when we say, now you have a friend in the car business.
Feel the energy, Mike Anderson.
basketball. WROI.
As we go to the second quarter, the Rochester Zebras lead 13-10. And the Fairfield Falcons, Tony, will get the ball to start the second period.
Yeah, as we said, good sign for the Zebras. A couple things. Number one, all five starters have scored, so you got some balanced scoring there. When they, the slower the pace of their offense is, the better shot selection, the better their offense is run. But now the big thing is with Luke Kennedy off the floor with two fouls, Zebras get a lot smaller, see if they go to maybe more quicker defense.
And John O'Dell then draws, lands down low. So DeWitt crosses the timeline, gets it to Stack, who works against Cy Holland. Now to Lance, tries back over to Scott and chucks it out of bounds. Nice defense for the Zebras to create that turnover, and the Rochester Zebras will get it back.
Definitely targeting Alec Garrick in the post on you know, Zebras playing defense, but he did a nice job holding his ground and getting that, not going after that pass. They can go out of bounds so the Zebras get the ball.
Right. So Odell holds on the left side, works against Lance in the man-to-man defense now by Fairfield. I believe this is the first time we've seen this as a scorer. Odell in the corner to wide-open Cy Holland for three. Left wing is no good. It's short. Lance comes out with a rebound and gives two to DeWitt. DeWitt pushes on the near side to Rhodes. Rhodes on the right wing. Cut off by the defense and sets Korn. Now to Stack. To Lance against Odell. Sends right side behind the arc to Rhodes. He'll fire a three. It's no good. DeWitt with the rebound. The putback is no good. Ball fought for. Lance comes out of there with it. Now we're going to have a foul, I believe, on Odell on the reach-in. No, we're going to... The official near to us calls a foul. The official under the basket who has a better look called a jump ball. And I believe the foul is going to come instead of the jump ball.
That's going to be Odell's first, Zebra's fifth of the half. So, again, two more offensive rebounds for Fairfield. I mean, that's the thing. And the Zebras are playing man-to-man. You've got to take care of the defensive boards.
Carter screening in the game for the first time for Rochester. And Holland sits down. Lance baby hook in the lane over Odell is no good. Corner of the rebound gives a screen. Rochester runs to our left, up by three at 13-10 with a minute gone here in the second quarter. Garrick, left side. Alec backs his way in, loses the handle, and picked up by Stack. And then his pass is deflected, but Rhodes has it, and off his hands out of bounds. Rochester going to dodge another bullet there on another turnover, and Fairfield going to give it back to them.
Situation there where Garrick probably took two dribble too many, got too far into the defense where he is out of control and maybe trapped a little bit. You got to make that pass one dribble sooner.
6:45 to play, first half. Rochester up 13-10. Cy Holland gives to Korn, left side, now to Garrick. Looking on the blocks at Holland, can't find him. Now to screen, top of the key. Back to Garrick, left wing. Now to Cy Holland, man-to-man defense by the Falcons to Seth Korn behind the arc in the right corner. 13-10 Rochester. Korn dribbles, loses the handle, grabs the basketball, gives the street now between the circles. Against DeWitt to a cutting Garrick, backs his way in, and he's going to be called for a travel. Yeah, it's tough to get a good look in there amongst the trees. And a travel against the Rochester Zebras and Alec Garrick.
I think he had Seth Korn. As Alec caught that pass, the defense kind of helped up. He was looking for a shot. If he would have kept his head up a little bit, I think he had Seth Korn behind the defense for a layup.
Rochester slips back into a 2-3 zone as Taylor Medina comes into the game for the first time and John O'Dell to sit. 6 minutes to play, first half. DeWitt kicks it out to Stack, looks at a three and passes it up. Now drives around the defense, kicks it out right wing to Rhodes. Rhodes gives back to DeWitt. Quickly left side to Stack. He'll fire the three for the tie. It's no good off the mark. And Seth Korn for Rochester with the rebound. Rochester up by three with 5:50 to play in the first half. Streeton to Cy Holland on the right wing. Back to Streeton. Man-to-man defense by Fairfield. Gives in the corner to Holland. Cy around the defense. In the paint. Tries to thread the needle. Picked off by Lance. And Fairfield, who gives to DeWitt. To Rhodes, high on the left side, back to DeWitt between the circles. Rochester in a 2-3 zone, high on the right side to Stack, back to DeWitt in the center circle, out to Rhodes. Lob pass back door to Stack. He puts a shot up, it's blocked by Korn, but ripped away by Scott, and his shot is no good, but a foul coming on Rochester. And I got to believe that Stack probably should have shot and caught instead of coming down.
Foul's going to be on Seth Korn. That's his first, team sixth.
Garrett Scott at the line for two.
Nice zone play by Fairfield. They took the action away from where they wanted to go, and on the weak side, they sealed the backside of the bottom of the 2-3 zone and threw a lob over the top.
DeWitt comes out of the game, line back in. John O'Dell back in for Rochester, and Seth Korn to sit. Scott misses his first free throw. He'll have one more for the Falcons. Second on the way is good this time. 13-11, Rochester on top. Rochester's held the lead the entire first half so far. We have 5:10 to play here in the first half. And Fairfield in that 2-2-1 press. Rochester crosses the timeline. Medina down low and has his pass stolen away by Rhodes. Rhodes right side of the floor for Fairfield. Now gives a stack quickly left side to Line. Line looking for Lance, but sends right side to Rhodes, and it's tipped out of bounds. The pass is by Odell. It'll stay right in front of the Rochester bench as Alec Holland comes back into the game, and Cy Holland assists.
Turnover is a big bugaboo for the Zebras here this quarter. You can tell they're trying to make that pass, but just not getting it on or not getting the right read or not making the correct pass. I think they've turned it over three out of the last four possessions.
Yeah. Scoring was going pretty well in the first quarter. It's come to a screeching halt here in the second one.
1 point between both teams. 3 minutes in.
13-11. Lance gets the backdoor pass again. His shot no good, but a foul coming in Rochester. And I believe Lance was undercut. He hit the ground or hit the floor hard, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
That same play they threw last time, just the other side of the floor. Zebra's got to be a heads up. They're just screening the backside of the 2-3 zone and sending a cutter behind it. They've got to make that adjustment. You can't get caught staring at the ball. That's Garrett's second foul, Zebra's seventh, so Fairfield shooting free throws the rest of the half.
4:38 to play in the first half. Lance at the line to try to tie this one up with two freebies. Brad Lance's first one is on the way. It's no good off the back of the iron. We'll have one more.
The shooting woes for Fairfield continue. Yeah. You know, they've had lots of shots inside 5 feet, and, you know, they've only made four shots from the field.
13-11, Rochester on top. Second free throw by Lance is good this time. 13-12. Zebras. Seth Korn back in the picks it up. Now to Stack. Another turnover on Rochester. Fairfield with an opportunity here to take the lead with this possession. Feeds in the baseline to Lance. Kicks it out to a wide open Scott for three. Top of the key is good. Fairfield up 15-13. And now Coach Reinholt will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world, especially now that basketball season has returned. So before heading to the gym or after the big game, even listening on the radio or watching on TV, enjoy the good times with family and friends and Coca-Cola. Grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. When you get together for exciting times, make sure you have plenty of terrific Coca-Cola products on hand, whether it's the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with anything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
You guys ready for the game?
All right. Well, management told me they weren't paying me for pep talk, so I'm going to stop now.
You know that place between saving money and sacrificing quality?
We are so there.
What's the point of saving money if you get lousy results? Especially when it comes to car insurance. State Farm can give you the right amount of coverage, plus with discounts up to 40%. You'll like how much you can save. State Farm is there.
That's Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017. State Farm Bank.
Discounts may vary 5 to 40%. State to state.
Yeah! Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4 minutes, 16 seconds to play in the first half. Fairfield now up for the first time tonight. 15-13, that comes off a big three by Garrett Scott. 2-2-1 zone again by Fairfield, and boy, Seth Korn's pass almost picked off again. But Rochester has it still. Screen between the rings. Runs the point for the Rochester Zebras against the 2-3 zone of the Fairfield Falcons. Near side to Holland. Alec Holland now holds. Sends right wing to Streeton. Carter inside the zone. Outside to Holland. Holland behind the arc on the baseline to Medina. Taylor Medina, a couple of dribbles. Tries to thread the pass. Boy, Rhodes almost picked it off, but Streeton has it. Then he throws it away.
Fairfield doing a very aggressive job in this zone. They're just anticipating and reading the next pass. It's not your, you know, it's not the zone that just reacts. They're reading the eyes of the Rochester passers and anticipating that next pass and making it very difficult for the Zebras to run any offense.
Rochester in a man-to-man defense and trailing by two with 3.5 to play in the second quarter. Line around Streeton, gives to Rhodes. Rhodes has been awfully quiet here in this first half. Down little Lance, he throws a turnover from Medina. It's no good, but a foul coming on the Zebras. And Brad Lance will go back to the line to shoot two for his Falcons.
It's going to be the Zebras' eighth team foul, Medina's first. Six players for Rochester have at least one foul. Garrick has two, Kennedy has two. All five starters have fouls, as well as now Taylor Medina.
Medina, I make that Lance, his first free throw is good. Well, Coach Reinholt pretty impressed with what he saw yesterday with Medina.
Well, the last few games, Medina has just come on a little bit stronger each game, and is really, a game like this, they need him. You know, with Lucia having foul trouble, he gives them a nice inside presence.
And he even mentioned in the pregame interview that Coach Kelly is going to see less and less from Taylor Medina on the JV floor.
Not a surprise.
So Lance hits both free throws. Fairfield up by 4, 17-13. Hauling around the defense. Feeds down low to Medina off his, I believe it was tipped, and then off the shoulder of Medina and out of bounds. And again, down the floor. Rochester.
Situation where nice look, but probably the wrong pass. He threw it to the open guy, but if it was a bounce pass, that probably gets through instead of deflected.
So Rochester uses a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here. So I don't know, that's three or four or five times down the floor now. Rochester's committed a turnover and given it back to Fairfield, which is how Fairfield has gotten back into this and now leads by 4.
Probably, I think the Zebras have only had a couple shots this quarter. I mean, they turned it over far more. You know, their offense is, on one hand, you like the fact that there's this group starting to look to make passes and run some offense, but telegraphing too much, maybe making the right look, but as I said, the wrong pass, need more bounce passes or really skip the ball a little bit quicker, and they're just not getting shots off at the rim. And you can rebound a missed shot. It's tough to rebound a turnover, and the offense is bogged down as a result.
So that 2-3 zone, both tonight and last night, really giving Rochester's offense fits.
Yeah, they just don't really have the shooters other than Odell that consistently knock down those shots.
Under 3 to play in the first half. 17-13 Fairfield, and now Rhodes will fire a 3. Nope. Weak side rebound, though, to Streeton. Streeton pushes for Rochester, down by 4. 2-3 zone by Fairfield to Odell on the left wing. John, one dribble back to Streeton. That 2-3 zone, Tony's almost a matchup man-to-man.
Yeah, they're definitely playing guys in their area a little more tight and then off when they don't have it.
Streeton to the near side. 2-3 zone by Fairfield. Gives the corner the right elbow. He'll take the long 18-footers off the mark. No good. And the rebound to Rhodes and Fairfield. Quickly to head to DeWitt. 2:20 to play first half. Down low to Lance. Lance backs his way in over Medina. The fall-away jumper is no good. Ball being tipped around. Lance comes out of there with it with an offensive rebound, and then he travels.
Fortunate for the Zebras there because, once again, sound like a broken record, but offensive rebounds and turnovers are killing the Zebras tonight. If they can take care of the ball and take care of the boards, they'd be in much better shape, but those two things are killing them right now.
You know, that's about three consecutive games. Tonight, of course, last night at Northwood, and then Lewis Cass last week. 17-13, Fairfield, 3 for Streeton is good. Carter Streeton doesn't take a lot of shots, but that one was a big one to cut the lead to 1 with a minute 45 to play in the first half.
And that's big because it's as bad as they've played. They're down 1.
Lyon then quickly goes to the basket hard off the baseline and pushes the lead back to 3 at 19-16 with a minute 35 to play in the first half.
The first player other than Scott or Lance to score for Fairfield.
Korn bounce pass to Holland. 2-3 zone for Fairfield with a minute 25 to play in the second quarter. Again, Fairfield up by 3 at 19-16. Medina on the baseline, turnaround jumper over. Lance goes. Nice looking shot by Taylor Medina. His first 2 of the game and cuts the lead again to 1.
That's where you can see the confidence. That's the shot. If you expect and are comfortable to play varsity basketball, you take that shot. 2 weeks ago, he wouldn't even look for it.
DeWitt gets a no-look pass from Scott and puts it in for another 2 with 60 seconds of play in the first half, 21-18 Fairfield. Holland breaks the press, gets it across to Korn, and Korn throws it away. And now DeWitt will walk it through the center circle with 45 to wide open Rhodes. Oh, boy, as misses Lance down low, wide open. Quickly to line to a cutting Rhodes in the lane. Turnaround baby hook is no good. The weak side rebound to Lance. He'll put it up. It's good and a foul. Another offensive board, this time turns into points for Fairfield, and Brad Lance will go to the line to shoot 1 for his Falcons. 37.6 to play in the first half. Jack back into the game, and Rhodes to sit for Fairfield.
Foul was on screen, unfortunate, because he wasn't the one that missed the block out, but he got left to clean up the mess.
So Lance at the free throw line. Looking to push this lead to 6, and he does so with a freebie. It's 24-18. 35 seconds of play in the second quarter. Streeton against the man-to-man press. Stack inside his jersey all the way up the floor with 29. And then the pass, like Tony says, was telegraphed again, and this time line knocked out of bounds. Fortunate to Rochester, they'll keep possession.
It's easy to guard the offense when all you're looking is perimeter passes. The Fairfield just waiting for that pass and anticipating and jumping in the passing lane.
Odell feeds down low to Medina. Medina is fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two. And I thought maybe Scott got that block clean, but they're going to say, I believe they got him on the body.
Yeah, it is on Scott, his first, only the third Fairfield team foul of the half. That's the time, though, Zebras got the ball middle. Somebody went to the middle. They'll turn and face the basket. The defense helped up. A nice bounce pass that got through to Medina.
Medina's good-looking free throw goes through. 23.5 seconds to play, first half. Medina with one more for the Zebras. Taylor ready. Second one is good again. 24-20. Fairfield on top. Rochester in a 2-2-1 press with 17 seconds. Lime and Fairfield not yet crossing the timeline. Finally does to Stack, to DeWitt, to a cutting Lance with 10. Kicks it out to Stack. Quickly near side or far side to Lime with 6 seconds. Lime back to Stack with 4, with 3, with 2. Stack to Rhodes. 3 at the buzzer on the way. Good! At halftime, Fairfield leads the Zebras 27-20. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
I'm just so impressed with Adrian Peterson to come back and be even better than he was.
As good as he is, he still needs nearly 300 yards in 2 games. I don't think that's feasible. I mean, it's possible for sure, but I don't think it's going to happen.
I don't know. The guy's come back from a shattered knee in less than a year. I wouldn't put anything behind him or his teammates to try to get him that record.
I'm going to go with Calvin Johnson breaking Jerry Rice's record that stood since 95.
All right, I'll take Peterson and loser buys next time.
Rochester starts the second half of the basketball. Alec Holland stands between the circles as Fairfield comes on the man-to-man defense. Rochester starts with the original five on the floor, Kennedy, Korn, Odell, Garrick, and Holland. And Rochester had the ball now for 40 seconds, and all they're doing is passing the ball, which is a good thing. Odell looks at a three, passes up, feeds down low to Kennedy. His shot's blocked from behind, gets his own rebound back. Blocked again, ball loose on the floor, and Fairfield comes out of there with it. Rhodes runs for the Falcons, up by 7. Now middle of the floor, swings left side to Stack. Stack misses DeWitt, flashing through the lane. Now Rhodes to DeWitt near side. Rochester in a man-to-man defense. A minute gone here in the third quarter. Fairfield up 27-20. Lance at the elbow left to DeWitt, to Rhodes, looking down low to Scott. Paul tipped away, and then Scott gets it back to Rhodes on the far side to Stack, to DeWitt. DeWitt looking down low for Scott. Garrick doing a good job bodying up on him to wide open DeWitt. His jumper over Kennedy is good. Fairfield up by 9 now at 29-20.
Fairfield switched to man-to-man. I like the Zebras' plan of attack. They moved the basketball a bit, and they got a post feed. And yeah, Kennedy missed a couple shots, but it's good to see him get to the post and then get him the ball.
Alec Holland on the baseline. Leaner is blocked from behind by Lance. Gets the shot back, gets the ball back. He goes up with it, and he is fouled on the shot by Scott. And Alec Holland, the freshman, will go to the line to shoot two for his Zebras.
That's the second foul on Scott, so if the Zebras can attack that, maybe get a third foul on him, it'd be big because Scott's got 13 points just in the first half. Alec Holland going to the line for the first time tonight, 2-2.
6:14 to play in the third quarter. Fairfield up 29-20, and Alec Holland at the line for two. First one's good by the freshman. He'll have one more.
Alec Collins shooting 71% from the line this year, so the freshman certainly, the free throw line is a good asset to his game.
Holland ready, sets himself, fires the second one, no good.
Jinx.
Stop the rebound.
My bad.
DeWitt quickly up the court to Rhodes. Rhodes left wing, top to Stack, now far side to DeWitt. Lobs back door to Lance, off the backboard, picked up by Rhodes. Nope, picked up by Scott. Quickly to DeWitt, now right side to Rhodes. He'll fire a three right to the face of Seth Korn, and it goes.
That young man, I think, had a big night last night, but that's his first points of this game.
And then the pass is knocked away by Fairfield. DeWitt saves from going out of bounds right to the hands of Stack. Stack to DeWitt, top of the key. To a wide open road. He'll fire a three again. Good. And now it's 35-21. Coach Reinhold, I think, was trying to get a timeout, and now he finally will get one, fortunately, because Alec Garrick's pass was picked off by Rhodes. It's a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Why do people love Nubiano's famous Italian pizza so much?
It makes me happy.
The gooey cheese.
The hand-tossed crust.
The toppings.
The homemade sauce.
The taste.
I don't know. I just love it.
Call Nubiano's at 223-4224. That's 223-4224. Dine in, carry out, and delivery is available. Don't forget, they also have delicious hot baked sandwiches and salads, too. Nubiano's Italian Pizza, 714 East 9th Street, Rochester. A Fulton County tradition since 1982.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Civic New Valley High School for the second round of the Winning Edge Holiday Tournament. Well, Rochester takes a timeout and immediately turns it over, and Scott goes in for an easy layup. Jeff Korn with the basketball, now to Odell. Fakes a three, drives the baseline, throws a shot up over Lance. It goes. Rochester needed that bucket. Still down by 14 points to 37-20 with under five to play in the third quarter.
It's only John's fifth point of the night, his first bucket since a three early in the game.
Lance gives to Stack. Baseline cut off by Korn to DeWitt. Part quickly to Rhodes to the far side. To Stack, top of the key. Stack then has it stripped away from behind to Holland. Holland goes in, fakes a shot, goes in. Oh, my gosh, he was mauled. Hit the ground hard, and no foul. Now we're going to have a foul on Rochester. Man, Alec Holland was fouled hard, and they're going to say he got all ball, and then we're going to have a foul on the Rochester Zebras coming the other way.
Foul's going to be on Odell. My gosh, the kid's arm almost got pulled out of socket as he went up for the shot and falls down. And then Odell gets a little bump, and they call foul on him.
Coach Rex Reinhold giving him an earful. I don't blame him. Holy moly. And Alec Holland very fortunate not to be hurt on that play.
Zebras in a 2-2-1 three-quarters court trap trying to turn the tempo of the game around.
And another foul on the Zebras. Is that going to be against Garrick?
That's Garrick. That's his third, and it is his third, team second.
Rochester foul number 24. 4:23 to play in the third quarter. Fairfield up 37-23, and the Falcons of the basketball going to our left. Rhodes through the double team, gives out the Stack. Cross court right to DeWitt. DeWitt around the defense, down the corner to Lance, down low to Scott. Ball is tipped away. They're going to say last touch by Garrett Scott. Rochester's going to get it back. Good defense by Seth Korn.
Yeah, he used his offhand to make a deflection, and then he deflected it off the shoe of the Fairfield player to get possession for the Zebras.
Rochester going to get it back. Seth makes that Cy Holland back into the game.
1-3-1 half-court trap by Fairfield. This is about the fourth different defense they've used tonight.
Holland loses it off his fingertips. Oh, they're going to say last touch by Scott. I believe that Cy might have been the one last one to touch that, but it will stay with Rochester right in front of the scoring bench. 4 minutes to play in the third. Rochester down by 14. Streeton crosses the timeline. Works left side to Holland. Cy, that is. And then his pass is blocked and tipped away and picked up by Scott. He'll go in for the shot. It's good. Pressure defense really calls on Rochester's offense fit.
17 points for Scott. Yeah, they have the big lanky guy at the top of the 1-3-1 against the short Zebra guard.
Yeah.
It is causing problems for the Zebra offense.
Streeton back to corner, the right corner. Sends left wing to Holland. Quickly to Odell for three. Left corner is good. 39-26. Lead is cut to 13 with 3:20 to play in the third. Against a double team now, and Fairfield will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
And yours True Value Hardware Rental and Paint Store, 1619 Main Street in Rochester, reminds you they have all the paint and paint supplies to make your home glow this holiday season. Choose Easy Care Interior Paint for one coat coverage. See Andrew's line of Melissa and Doug toys. They have the largest selection in the area, and these beautiful toys are child safe and child friendly. For holiday gift giving, check out Enyart's line of housewares. They've added to their selections to make your shopping easier. And from lighted trees to a full line of holiday decor, including wrapping paper, light sets, garlands, surge strips, gifts, bags, and tags, well, Enyart's has you covered. Enyart's True Value. Start right. Start here.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
3:21 to play in the third quarter. Fairfield leading 39-26. And the Falcons, after their timeout, will have the basketball cross court right at the timeline. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. We're at Tippecanoe New Valley High School for the consolation game of the Winning Edge Holiday Tournament. Championship game will feature Tippecanoe New Valley and Northwood. Stack gives to Lance. Lance has been quiet here in this second half. To DeWitt. DeWitt, back door to Lance. Really high lob is tipped away. And somehow, Fairfield comes out of there with it. Stack gives to DeWitt. Nice hands by DeWitt. To Lance, to Stack. Stack then carries the basketball, and it'll go back to Rochester.
Big important possession for the Zebras if they're going to continue. Fairfield, that is, going to continue this 1-3-1 trap or the pressure. The Zebras have to make that possession like they did last time. Look diagonal, move the ball quickly, and you're going to get a good look.
And it looks like a 2-3 zone now.
Yeah.
For Fairfield.
They've done a good job tonight of, I think, confusing the Zebras a little bit. Some young players on the floor, they've changed their defenses every few possessions, and the Zebras have had to adjust.
Yeah, defense, even though it's a 2-3, it's still in your face, even at the volleyball line. Odell's pull-up 10-footer is good. John Odell.
Jonathan Odell.
Cuts the lead to the 11. It's 39-28 with 2.5 to play in the third.
That's his 7th point of the quarter, and he's got 10 for the night now.
Miller gives top to DeWitt, quickly in the corner to line. Down low to Lance. Back to line. Lobs over the defense to DeWitt. At the elbow to Scott, down little Lance. Lance's shot is good and a foul. Luke Kennedy just picked up his third foul. And Lance will go to the line to shoot one free throw for the Falcons.
Zebras, a little bit of a zone there. Slow rotations. They're reacting. They're waiting until somebody makes the catch and then moving instead of moving when the ball's in the air.
2:17 to play in the third quarter. Free throw for Lance is good. 42-28, Fairfield, and now they're in a 2-1 zone press against the Rochester Zebras. Cy Holland gives to Streeton. Gets it across the timeline to Korn. Korn in the right wing to Kennedy. So Kennedy outside to Holland. Side between the leg dribble. Works against 2-3 zone. In the paint to Streeton. Down low to Kennedy. Loose Kennedy. The shot is good. Nice pass by Street. Good finish by Kennedy. And the lead is down to 12. Minute 50 to play. And then a turnover. John Odell has it. Right side of the floor. And then has it stripped. He gets it back. Throws a shot up. A shot. Partially blocked. Picked up by Scott. Ahead to DeWitt.
I think he was trying to draw a foul, but he had, I think, Cy Holland on the opposite block wide open if he would have thrown that pass.
I think he was fouled. I think he did a good job doing it. He just didn't get the call.
I don't know if I'd take my chances trying to get a foul with the way this half has been called.
Scott misses the jumper. He gets his own rebound. Gives down a little line. His layup is good. Cy Holland comes out of there wiping his nose looking for blood. A minute 10 to play in the third quarter. It's a 14-point lead for Fairfield. Streeton gets ahead to Cy Holland. Holland in the corner to Odell. Dribbles, bounce pass to Holland, top of the key. Out to Odell for three. A quick three from the corner is no good. Kennedy with the rebound. Luke against Lance, throws up a shot, it's good. Nice looking shot by Luke Kennedy. And it's 44-32, 45 to play in the third. Half court trap by the Zebras. DeWitt quickly to wide open line for three. No good. Ball being tipped around. Whoa, Luke Kennedy hits the ground, hits the floor hard. First thing he hits is his butt, then his head. He rolls around, then he's going to be held to his feet. A little dazed, it looks like, as he's rubbing the back of his head.
And watch it one.
And now Holland comes back in, and he'll replace Streeton with 39.9 to play in the third quarter. It's a 12-point lead for Fairfield. Line looks to get it in. And then throws it right in the hands of Cy Holland. Holland runs for Rochester. Holland then is body checked by DeWitt. And it'll stay, it'll be out of bounds for Rochester right in front of their own bench.
It's going to be DeWitt's first team's second foul to half. The fifth team foul called on Fairfield the game.
The Rochester Zebra fans give the officials a sarcastic cheer.
Oh, the joy of consolation crowds. Plenty of seats still available if you're out and about.
Hey, speaking of tourneys, when is yours and who do you play?
The 27th, we play Kankakee Valley at Knox High School at 6 o'clock. And then the second evening or second afternoon games are on the 29th at West Central against either West Central or Argus.
Okay. Scott loses the basketball to the hands of Kennedy with Kennedy, that is, with 14 seconds. Out of sight, Holland with 10. Holland in the right corner. A couple of dribbles to the wing with 6. Holland holds. Got to get rid of it. Now to Kennedy with 4. Kennedy on the baseline with 3. Pull-up jumper with 2. It is no good. Rebound to Fairfield, and that'll do it for the third quarter. After 3, the Falcons lead 44-32. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's Table since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
WROI Rochester.
RTC Channel 4 is happy to offer the following videos for this week. You will see the RHS Holiday Concert daily at 11 a.m., 3:30 p.m., and 7 o'clock p.m. And you may also watch RTC's own segment called This Week on Channel 4 at 10:30 a.m., 1:30 p.m., and 6 o'clock p.m. If you have a suggestion for a future Channel 4 video, please call Dee Brown at RTC number 223-2191. Keep up to date with RTC happenings by liking Rochester Telephone Company on Facebook. Merry Christmas and a very happy new year.
Fairfield leads by 12 as we go to the fourth and final quarter here in the consolation game of the Winning Edge Holiday Tournament here at Tippecanoe Valley High School. Fairfield Falcons start with the basketball. Rochester in a zone look. Line for 3 is short, and Taylor Medina with the rebound. Here's a look that we almost saw entirely last night, but Seth Korn is on the floor right now.
Yeah, Alec Holland back in the game. Medina back in the game. Fairfield man-to-man. See if we can get some offense going here and chop into this lead.
12-point lead for Fairfield. Rochester once held a 9-0 lead, and that's been about it. Corner of the lane, shot no good. And Scott with a rebound. Garrett Scott will bring it up the floor, gives a line high on the right side to a cutting Lance. And his pass is tipped away and stolen by Rochester. Alec Holland now pushes and pulls back to set up a play between the rings at the volleyball line with 7:15 to play in the game. Rochester down by 12. Holland around the defense. Cut off by DeWitt, out to Garrick. Garrick dribbles to the top of the key, jump pass to Holland in the left corner. Alec, that is. Alec Holland now dribbles to the top of the key, gives to Medina, ball loose, and then picked up in the backcourt. They're going to say deflected by Line. It goes into Fairfield's backcourt, and then Rhodes is going to come over the back of Cy Holland and commit a foul. It'll be Rochester basketball on the far side with 6:50 to play in the game.
Rhodes' first team's third.
20, Marcus Rhodes, his first team's third.
Stack coming back into the game and line to sit for Fairfield. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman.
Fairfield's doing a nice job on defense of switching the perimeter screens and pushing the Zebra ball handlers out of their offense. It's hard to run offense 30 feet from the basket.
Medina's shot just inside the arc is good. Good looking shot by Medina.
He's got 6.
And the lead is cut to 10. Half court trap. 1-3-1.
Ooh, take that.
DeWitt throwing against official.
That's a nice look. Medina there at the top of that, using a little bit of size athleticism. A nice look. He's going to check out of the game, but that might be something Coach comes back to later on down.
Fairfield will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Why purchase a new or pre-owned vehicle from Mike Anderson? This is John Adair, General Manager, and after visiting with a satisfied customer, this is what they told me. I never felt pressured. I appreciated the salesperson's honest approach. He explained why we might want to consider a different vehicle. than the one we originally thought I wanted. I was amazed at how easy it was to get financed, and my salesperson took the time to explain all the features of my car before I even drove off the lot. So the fact is, at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram Truck, we want every one of our customers to say, "I love my car," after the sale. We mean it when we say, "Now you have a friend in the car business."
SMU and Fresno State.
The Hawaii Bowl. Welcome back to Tippecanoe Valley High School.
Up here for the rainbows. Could even make their own bowl.
Rochester down by 10 at 44-34 with 6.5 to play in the game. And after the Fairfield timeout, the Zebra will have the basketball. Tony and I just talking about the 8:30 game tonight. I can't remember who it is, but I think there's one on ESPN. I'm sure I can find something. Alex Holland on the wing. Works against the Fairfield's man-to-man defense. The screen now to Odell, high on the left side.
Oh, you know what it is tonight? Monday Night Football.
Oh, that's what it is.
That's it.
No bowl. You're right.
The Lions and Falcons.
Shot by Kennedy's good for 15-foot, and Rochester's got the lead to under 10.
8 points for Luke.
I'm hoping that Calvin Johnson goes for 184 tonight. I need him for my chance for the championship game of the Fantasy League. Oh, geez. Fairfield beats the press easily, but the two-footer or less by Lance does not go, and Rochester has a chance to cut this within eight. 44-36, Fairfield was once a what, 15 or 16-point lead, and Rochester has an opportunity to cut this to six, maybe even to five with this possession, and then it's turned over right into the hands of Scott. Garrett Scott will go to the basket. The ball's tipped away by Streeton out of bounds. It'll stay with Fairfield baseline right.
Good hustle by Carter. Instead of jumping to try to block the shot, he kind of cut in and dislodged the ball as he was going on the way up. Just nobody for Rochester there to kind of pick it up because he can't touch it then.
5.5 to play in the game, 44-36 Fairfield. And the lob pass comes into Lance at the elbow to Scott. Scott then has it ripped away by Garrick, and Rochester coming the other way, going to our right.
It's a big possession here.
Odell for three on the left side is short. Kennedy the rebound. The putback is good. The lead is down to six, 44-38 with 5:15 to play in the game.
Double figures for Luke Kennedy.
Pass is almost tipped away and stolen by Rochester. Going to say last touch by the Falcons. And it's going to go back to the Zebras, down by six.
Nice little spark for the Zebras. The bench is in it. The guys are in it. Clawed back. You're down six. Again, see if you maybe go back to the big man inside. Get a good possession, a good look. Work your offense. 5 minutes to go. Plenty of time left. Work your offense. Get a good shot.
Well, they could have just went away and hit with down by 16, but these kids have fought back and got it to within six with the basketball. Kennedy at the free throw line. Turnaround jumper is off the mark. No good. The putback is no good by Odell. And we're going to have a foul down low. Who's that going to be whistled against? The Zebra fans think it's going to be against Rhodes and the Falcons. Well, it's going to be against the Falcons. Did he call that on 10?
Yeah.
Oh, there he is. Yeah.
Yeah. His third, team's fourth. Zebra's not shooting yet.
Holland for three. In and out, no good. Lance with the rebound. Boy, that's great lock. And then almost stolen by Odell, but picked up by Fairfield. And then Odell is going to pick up a foul at his own free throw line with 4:40 to play in the basketball game. Fairfield now up by six.
John almost got the first steal hanging around, and then he stuck around maybe a little too long, got his hand in the cookie jar, and that's going to be his third, team's fourth.
Here comes the half-court trap by the Zebras. Pass almost stolen, but gotten to DeWitt. And then his pass is stolen by Kennedy. To Streeton. 4:25 to play in the game. Rochester down 44-38. Here comes Fairfield's half-court trap. To Holland, around the defense. Throws up a shot over Lance. A lot of contact, no foul. And then Luke Kennedy comes over the back hard of Lance. And he's just picked up his fourth personal foul.
Yeah, that's desperate trying to make a play. Thought he could have it, but again, the way game's been called, you can't blame a kid for maybe making a little extra effort, because about the time you think it's going to be a foul, there's no call, so these guys are trying to make extra plays, because, you know, I think a couple different officials have different philosophies on what they're calling, and it just kind of depends on who's the closest guy in the area.
Yeah. And with his fourth personal foul, Kennedy comes out and sets Corn back into the game.
Chance for the Zebras to get a little quicker, maybe pick up the pressure a little bit.
4:15 to play in this basketball game. Fairfield by 6 at 44-38. Scott down low to Lance against Odell. His pass is tipped out of bounds by Garrick. Probably just should have turned around and shot it, I'm guessing. And it'll stay with Fairfield baseline right underneath their own basket.
John's playing the back of that defense. He's got to make sure he's moving all the time. He's the last line of defense against the big guys.
DeWitt lobs it to Rhodes. He'll take a three over Odell. It's good. That's a big shot by Rhodes, who was about 3 or 4 feet behind the three-point line. Pushes this lead back to nine.
He's got nine on three threes just in this half.
Holland for three, left wing. It's good. And now the lead down to six with 3:40 to play in the game.
Six for Holland.
2-2-1 zone press by the Zebras. Rhodes to DeWitt. Out to line for three. Nope. Nice block out by Garrett. Grabs the board, and he's going to be fouled by Garrett Scott.
If that's going to be his fourth if they call it on Scott. And it is. It's his fourth, Fairfield's fifth.
3:28 to play in the game. Rochester has cut this lead to six at 47-41, and they'll have the basketball going to our right.
That was a big rebound by Alec Garrick. We said one of the problems the Zebras have had is taking care of their boards. He's done a nice job of rebounding this half.
Yep. Straight into the wing. Down low to Odell. Quick turnaround. 10-footers off the glass. No good. And Scott with a rebound. High above the rim and grabs the board. And now gives to DeWitt. 3:08 to play in the game. Rhodes to Lance. Quickly to DeWitt. To line. Down low to Scott. Backs away in. Baby hook over. Seth Corn is no good. And we're going to have a foul on Garrick on the push off. And it's going to be out of bounds to Fairfield baseline left. I don't think they needed a foul. Needed to push off there. Had an easy rebound.
I think he would have had a clean rebound. I think he may have thought the guy was going to come in to rebound, so he's going to go block him out, and the guy peeled back, and he got caught extending his arm. It's going to be his fourth. He's going to sit. Luke Kennedy is going to come back in with four.
Rhodes looks to get it in baseline left. Looking. Lobs in and over the defense to DeWitt. The line behind the arc on the right side. Back to DeWitt, top of the key. Rochester in a 2-3 zone. Back to line, high on the right side. Cross court to Rhodes for three, left baseline. Good. And the lead is back to nine. 2:40 to play in the game.
Another three for Rhodes. He's got four just in this half.
Streeton for three, right wing. Nope. Throws nothing but air. And the rebound to Scott. Scott pushes up the floor for Fairfield to line. 9-point lead for Fairfield. And Coach Beachy for Fairfield tells him to spread the floor and work the clock. Line for three, left side, yep. 53-41, and Coach Reinhold will use another timeout. It's a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world, especially now that basketball season has returned. So before heading to the gym or after the big game, even listening on the radio or watching on TV, enjoy the good times with family and friends and Coca-Cola. Grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. When you get together for exciting times, make sure you have plenty of terrific Coca-Cola products on hand. Whether it's the store or the vending machine, Coca-Cola products go great with anything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Well, we're still catching every game, just a lot more from home than here in the stands, huh?
Yeah, and when we do get to go, Dad says we got to bring our own peanuts and stuff.
Looking for some extra ticket money this season? Let a State Farm agent do a free discount double check that could save you hundreds of dollars on car insurance.
We'll always be there for this team, even when we can't actually be here.
Get started by contacting State Farm agent Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017.
State Farm is there. Discounts may vary state to state.
Zebra Basketball. WROI.
2 minutes, 17 seconds to play in the game. Fairfield just went from being up by 6 to up by 12.
Here's a trivia question for you. How many threes has Fairfield hit this game? What would be your guess? Not looking at the stats.
You know what? I'll say 9.
You are correct, sir. 9. 9 threes. Including all 9 of their points have been three-pointers this quarter.
Two big ones here in the last two possessions.
You're right.
One by Lyon and the one by Scott. So Rochester loses the basketball. Another turnover on the Zebras, and Fairfield going to get it back with 2 minutes to play in the game.
I think these last couple possessions, John just been trying to do too much. The offense was moving when guys were moving and the ball was moving. The ball stopped moving, and the Zebras have stopped scoring.
2-2-1 zone press by the Zebras. Fairfield still hasn't got across the timeline. Now finally does to DeWitt. Now Scott pulls it out and runs some clock with a minute 40 to play in the game. DeWitt has it now. Rochester's going to have to start fouling, and right there was a foul with no call. Lying around the defense to a wide-open Rhodes. Rhodes dribbles in, then kicks it out to DeWitt. Back to Rhodes on the right wing with a minute 30 to play. Rochester down by 12. When do you start fouling, Tony?
Should be already.
Line on the left wing. Line dribbles out of trouble, gives to Rhodes. Back to line, left side. In the lane to Scott, wide open to Lance. Layup is good. Makes that no good and a foul. Boy, Lance has had a bunch of those bunnies that probably should have been down. And him going to the line for a three-point play, but that time he missed the shot. He'll go to the line for two with a minute 18 to play in the game. Rochester down by 12.
Yeah, Fairfield coaches are going to look at this game and say, you know, if we hit, 50% of our shots inside 5 feet that we miss, it's probably more comfortable margin for them.
Lance, first one is no good. He'll have one more. Alec Garrett comes back into the game, and Alec will replace Carter Street for Rochester. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Time ticking away here in the consolation game of the winning edge holiday tournament here at Tippecanoe Valley High School. Brad lands for Fairfield with one more free throw. It is no good again, and corner to the board. 12-point deficit right now. Rochester trying to make up. Odell with a long three off the back of the iron. No good. Kennedy looking to grab the rebound and knocks it out of bounds. It'll go back to Fairfield with 69 seconds to play in the game.
That was about three steps behind the line.
At least. He almost shot that from the first row of the stands.
Yeah.
Rochester not fouling yet. Line to Rhodes. A minute to play in the game. Ball is tipped away and stolen by Korn. Bounce pass to Odell. Right-handed layup is no good. The follow by Garrick is no good. And the rebound is to Garrick. And we're going to have a tie-up, and Rochester going to keep possession.
That's a case where Rochester guys actually battling each other for that rebound, which gave Fairfield a chance to come in and make a play and tie the ball up.
53.7 to play in the game, and inbound pass is stolen by Lance.
I think John was maybe trying to throw it off of a Fairfield player, but it didn't work.
DeWitt picking his way through traffic, gives to Scott outside to Lance, and Lance is found by Odell, and Lance and Fairfield will not shoot yet with 42 seconds to play in the game.
Odell's
oh,
fourth.
They will.
Yeah, Odell's fourth, team's eight.
So Brad Lance will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus with 42.3 to play in the game. Fairfield up by 12 at 53-41. First one of the way for Lance is good.
Lance had 10 at half, and that is point number 14 for him for the game.
One more coming for the senior Lance. Second one is good again, and now the lead is back to 14. Biggest lead, I think, has been 16 tonight for Fairfield. Quickly up the floor is Odell. Right baseline, his pull-up jumper's no good, but he is fouled on the shot. Coach Todd Troy Beachy not real happy with that foul by his team. And Odell will go to the line to shoot two with 36.5 to play in the game. Fairfield leading 55-41.
Joe Line, second, team six.
Taylor Medina will come in after the first free throw. Odell's shot is in and out, no good.
Odell's first appearance at the line tonight.
Luke Kennedy is done. He had a good night.
He did. You know, it's no fault of his own. That's sometimes the tough life of being a post player. Sometimes you rely on the guards to get you the ball, and when they were getting him the ball, he was scoring. And then this fourth quarter, second half of the fourth quarter, they haven't found him, and he hasn't gotten the ball, so he hasn't scored.
Second free throw is good by Odell. Cuts the lead to 13 at 55-42. Down to 30 seconds of play in the game. Bond trigger. Now quickly to head to Lance. Lance almost loses it, and Odell fouls him again. 26 and a half to play in the game. Lance will go back to the line to shoot free throws with his team up by 13.
That's John's fifth. Carter Screen will come in for him, and Mr. Lance will go back to the line.
Gets his head that tan.
Ooh, trust me, you can burn the top of your head. That's the worst thing.
In a tanning bed? I'm assuming that's where it came from, but I don't know.
Maybe he just came back from Florida.
Maybe he did.
But I'll tell you what, you burn the top of your head, that's the worst. That's like 10,000 needles poking you in the head, especially when you take a shower. That is the worst pain. Trust me, from experience. And then when it peels, it's like snowing, the dandruff so bad.
Lance hits one of two. Corner of the rebound with 24 seconds. Well, I'm going to find out here. Sorry, soon.
You turn into this radio show. Hey, Jack, you don't know what you're going to hear.
That was an awesome episode, by the way, on Duck Hunters.
Duck Dynasty.
Duck Dynasty, yeah. When he went to the radio station with Willie, that was awesome. 9 seconds. Holland's layup is no good. Rebound by Fairfield. That's going to do it. Fairfield's going to defeat the Rochester Zebras, 56-42. And Rochester going to slip to 1-7 on the year. Post-game thoughts coming up after this on 92.1 WROI.